Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to simplify two problems when both decimals and fractions are in the same expression, and this will include negative numbers. We do these two problems. All right, we need to simplify this expression, so we've got to use the order of operations. And so the first thing we need to do is simplify within the parentheses. So notice I have 4.7 minus 5.9. That's going to give me a negative number. I'm going to rewrite this as plus a negative. So I'm adding a positive and a negative number, and there are more negatives, so my answer is going to be negative. So I know whatever it is, it's going to be negative something. And since I'm adding with different signs, I take their difference. So over here on the side, I'm going to do the 5.9 minus the 4.7, which is 1.2. So I have negative 1.2. Now at this point, you have a multiplication, and there's different ways you can go from here. What you could do is change this negative 1.2 to a fraction. Or you could change this 3/8 to a decimal. That's one possibility, or two possibilities so far. Or what you could do is write this negative 1.2 as negative 1.2 over 1. So I'm going to show you the three ways you might do this problem. All of them valid. One way is change 3/8 to a decimal. Now, I'm not going to show the work here, but if you change 3/8 to a decimal, remember you're doing 3 divided by 8, you get 0.375, and you multiply that by negative 1.2. Okay, so that's one possibility, change 3/8 to a decimal. Another possibility is write negative 1.2 as a fraction. So notice there's only one digit after the decimal point, so you could write that as 3/8 times negative 12/10. See how I'm writing that as a fraction? So that's a different way of looking at it. And the other way is to write this as 3/8 times, and think of this as a negative 1.2 over 1, and then we're going to, instead of reducing, we'll multiply the numerators and denominators together. Okay, these are all valid approaches to this problem. All right, so in the first way you have to do that multiplication, the answer is going to be negative because in all of these problems you're multiplying a negative times a positive. And so you would multiply 375 times 12, move the decimal place in 4 digits. I'm not going to show the multiplication here, but this is what you would get. It's going to be negative 0.45 after you've done that multiplication. So that's the answer. And of course, if you could use a calculator, that's the easiest way to do it. All right, now how about this second way over here? It's going to be negative again because I have a positive times a negative, and let's see, can we reduce anything? Well, between the 8 and the 12, I could divide both of those by 4. So that's a 2 and that's a 3, and nothing else cancels. So that gives me 9/20. So notice I have 3 times 3, 9/20. And that's a reduced answer written as a fraction. Now, if you took 9/20 and divided, you would get 0.45. If you took 0.45 and wrote it as a fraction, 45 hundredths, and reduced it, you would get the 9/20. So these are exactly the same number. One's written in decimal form, one's written as a fraction. All right, how about over here? What about if I just multiply the numerators and then divide by 8? So that's another approach. So in the numerator, I have 3 times negative 1.2. So we know it's going to be negative. And I do 3 times 12 to get 36. And then I'm going to move my decimal in 1 place because there's one digit after the decimal point over 8. And now what you could do is divide 8 into that. Now this is going to be negative still, right? And I'm going to show the division. So if you did 8 into 3.6, you would just do the long division. So 8 goes into 36 four times. 5, so notice you get negative 0.45 again. All right, so three ways, three approaches, and I'm sure there's more that you could think of, or somebody could think of, to do this problem. But the answer written as a decimal would be the negative 0.45. The answer written as a fraction would be negative 9/20. Right, here's the next example. So we're going to do our order of operations again. So we have a fraction, 2/5, minus 3 times 2.3. So the first thing we need to do is our multiplication over here, because we're using order of operations. By the way, feel free to put the video on pause and try this on your own first. So I need to do 3 times 2.3. All right, well, remember all we do is do 3 times 23, which is 69, and then we can move the decimal in one place. Now at this point, the question is, would it be easier to change everything to fractions or decimals? And I think with 6.9, I would just leave everything as decimals. So let's write 2/5 as a decimal. So how do we do that? Well, 2/5 means 2 divided by 5. So that's one way of getting it. Going to get 0.4. Some people write it with 10 in the denominator, multiplying top and bottom by 2, and then they know that could be written as 4/10 as 0.4. In any case, 2/5 is the same thing as 0.4 minus 6.9. All right, now I'm subtracting a bigger number, so I'm going to change this to add the opposite plus a negative. And now I'm adding a positive and a negative, and there are more negatives, right? So my answer is going to be negative, and we take their difference. 6.9 minus 0.4, line up the decimal points, and we've got 6.5. Now, you could have done this with fractions as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and just do it for fun. All right. 2/5. If you wanted to leave that as 2/5. Now, what does 6.9 mean? If I want to write that as a fraction, it's simply 69/10 because there's only one digit after the decimal point. And in order to subtract fractions, you need to get a common denominator. So the common denominator would be 10. Let me move this over a little bit. So I would have, I don't know what happened to my minus sign, there it is. So I would have to multiply the 2/5 by 2 over 2. And that gives me 4/10 minus 69/10. And I'm going to change that to adding the opposite. So that gives me negative 65/10. Now that could be reduced to write it as a fraction, or we can now change that to a decimal because negative 65 divided by 10 means you move the 65, the decimal point, in one, negative 6.5. So if I were going to write it as a decimal, I would just divide by 10 by moving the decimal in one place. And then you can always write that as a mixed number, negative 6.5 would be negative 6.5. So again, there's more than one way to write the answer here, negative 6.5 or negative 6.5. And then negative 6.5 also could be written as an improper fraction, which you could have gotten from just reducing this fraction, negative 65/10. If you divide the top and bottom by 5, you get negative 13/2. Which of course is the same as negative 6.5, which is the same as negative 6.5. So it sort of depends how you simplify at the end what your final answer might look like. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.